Hello, my name is David, David Okonkwo, and thank you for joining us today. So here we are again in a new liturgical year, a new set of readings from the Bible spread out for us to begin our new journey. Have you taken the time to ask yourself the question, why do we start afresh every year at the same time? What does that mean for us? And hopefully, we are aware that a new liturgical year just began with the season of Advent. So why? Well, firstly, a new opportunity for all of us to take stock and start over anew in this journey of our salvation. Jesus had went around our whole town, our whole country. He had been to the churches and every worshiping site. He had been generously given us lives back, healing those in the hospitals and healing places in different places. But in time he comes out. He sees us looking pitiful, hopeless, troubled, and feeling abandoned, looking like sheep without shepherd. We are bogged down with the heaviness of life, worries of this and that, our jobs, our families, our friends. We try to please people in our lives with gifts. We try to make ourselves happy by buying one thing or the other. We fall prey to the ads on TV, media marketing campaigns, built up cultures of buying. Is it the Black Friday or the marketing countdown to the 25th of December at every store? We are bogged down. Instead, our Lord God says today, from the book of Isaiah, that the Lord will give you the bread you need and the water for which you thirst. No longer will he hide from us, but will be right beside us. Whispering into our ears his direction, when to turn and how long to walk and to get so personal with our Lord God. We must come to him. We must prepare ourselves, our ways, our lives. Advent is the time. This is why we are given this moment each year to prepare and re-prepare ourselves, to wait for him while we prepare for him in our lives. For he will give us rain for all of our labor for a great harvest. But be warned, all who do not prepare on that day, the light from the moon will be like that of the sun, and the sun's light seven times greater. So let us hear this message that the kingdom of heaven is at hand. Let us prepare ourselves for the coming of the newborn king. Let us pray. Great are you, Lord, and mighty in power. To your wisdom there is no limit. You, Lord, sustains the lowly and casts out the wicked. You heal the brokenhearted and binds their wounds. Praise be to you, Lord, our King, for you are good. We will sing praise and glorification to you, for you are gracious. Come, Lord Jesus, come. Rebuild our hearts and lives in us. Rebuild our city, our state, and our country. Help us to prepare ourselves and lie in wait for your coming. Amen.
Thank you for partnering with WordNet. Now, we have an easy and fun way of making your donations to WordNet. Use the number that is on the screen to text your amount and follow the on-screen instructions. Thank you very much, and be blessed always.